is Barack Hussein Obama? We know he is not a natural-born citizen, as required of a president by the Constitution. At best, with a father who was a Kenyan citizen, he was born with dual citizenship. We know his grammar school records while in Indonesia state he became an Indonesian citizen with the adopted name of Barry Satoro. In 2008, when questions surrounding Obama's citizenship filled the news cycle, the Obama campaign supposedly answered all critics by releasing the so-called short-form birth certificate. It proved nothing, being nothing but a computer printout, not listing any pertinent information such as the doctor's name, nationality of parents, etc. Calls for the original long-form birth certificate were ignored. There were dozens of legal challenges to Obama's eligibility. All of the challenges were treated by the courts as a circus sideshow, not as it should have been, as a potential constitutional crisis. We were told that the short-form birth certificate was the only birth certificate that existed. Later, we were told that the long-form birth certificate existed, but that it was virtually impossible for the Hawaii State Department of Health to release it. This we knew to be a lie. After Obama refused to release his original birth certificate, calls for other records to substantiate not only his citizenship, but the supposed narrative of his life were called for. The American people tried in vain to find out about the lost years of Obama's existence. His college records were sealed. His records while an attorney were sealed. His records while a state senator were supposedly lost. We did find out that Obama, as a state senator, developed an extremely close relationship with the DSA, the Democratic Socialists of America, that lasted for years, if not decades. In 1996, the DSA backed Obama for Illinois State Senate. In 2000, the DSA continued to support Obama, this time when he was running for Congress. Obama had been a dues-paying member of the DSA's political party, the openly Marxist New Party. In fact, we knew through New Party documents the exact day Obama joined, January 11, 1996. The New Party News, a publication of the New Party in 1996, had identified Obama as a New Party member, along with Danny Davis, who at the time was a card-carrying member of the CPUSA, the U.S. branch of the Communist Party. We did find out that while there is a record of Obama graduating from Columbia University, at a recent 30-year reunion, not one single student remembered Obama. Furthermore, a retired history professor, Henry Graff, whose classes Obama would have had to take in order to graduate, says Obama never attended Columbia. On April 27, 2011, a full 3 years after calls for the long-form birth certificate began, Obama finally released not a certified copy of the birth certificate, but an electronic PDF file. Within hours, the PDF of the birth certificate was found to have an endless amount of anomalies. Multiple layers, 8 different fonts, bitmap versus grayscale, misspelling on the registrar's stamp, just to mention a few of the dozen or so problems. After being petitioned by his constituents to look into Obama's birth certificate, Arizona Sheriff Joe Arpaio assigned a team to forensically examine the PDF birth certificate. The result was that he would find that not only was the birth certificate a forgery, but Obama's selective service form was forged as well.
We are prepared today to say we believe probable cause exists indicating that forgery and fraud may have been committed, not only in President Obama's long-form birth certificate, but more disturbing evidence suggests that another fraud may have been committed regarding his selected service registration card. At the very least, I can tell you this. Based on all of the evidence presented and investigated, I cannot, in good faith, report to you that these documents are authentic. My investigators believe that the long-form birth certificate was manufactured electronically and that it did not originate in a paper format as claimed by the White House.
Almost from day one of his presidency, Barack Hussein Obama began to bankrupt this country with a massive trillion-dollar stimulus, trillion-dollar bank bailouts, billions in loans to his cronies for so-called green energy, companies like Solyndra, that quickly went bankrupt. Obama shoved socialized healthcare down the throat of America, a program that is driving up the cost of health insurance and is projected to cost almost $2 trillion just in the first decade. Obama has continually tried to disarm the American public, attempting to nullify the Second Amendment through a phony so-called assault weapons ban. Not to mention trying to sidestep Congress by illegally signing the United Nations Small Arms Treaty. This so-called treaty will put technocratic regulations above the Constitution. Obama shipped guns to Mexican drug cartels in the Fast and Furious program in order to blame the increase in drug cartel violence on American gun dealers in order to limit our Second Amendment rights. Included in the thousands of guns shipped to Mexico are the weapons used to murder Border Patrol agent Brian Terry and ICE agent Jaime Zapata. Obama is in the strictest sense of the term an accessory to murder. Obama has targeted his enemies with the IRS, the Tea Party, pro-life groups, any group or person that opposes his radical leftist policies. Obama has targeted the press, including Fox News and the Associated Press. Obama has taken the so-called Patriot Act to an unimaginable Orwellian level. The NSA, under a program we now know called PRISM, is spying on every single American, ingesting literally everything that is communicated electronically. Phone calls, email, text, Facebook posts, Skype, travel records, even credit card transactions and banking records. Obama has no regard for the American people. Obama has no regard for the rule of law. Obama has no regard for the Constitution. Barack Hussein Obama, or Barry Satoru, or whatever his real name is, should be removed from office immediately, should be impeached for high crimes and misdemeanors now, today.